Hollywood, the land of glitz and glam, the land of everything rich and famous, the home of our favorite superstars. We watch movies in order to escape reality, yet we find ourselves constantly trying to find people who look like us on the big screens. Hollywood has been producing movies ever since 1910, and over 100 years later, although a lot of progress has been made, Hollywood continues to lack in the cultural diversity department. It makes me so happy that a lot of POC actors have made it to mainstream media, including Lupita Nyong'o, Chadwick Boseman, Awkwafina, Samuel L. Jackson, and more. It shows that Hollywood is making progress, but it doesn't mean they have made it there yet. There is still a long way to go until there is true cultural diversity in the films we view. Let's talk about the lack of diversity, how and why it happens, and why we need more mainstream POC actors in the film industry. Let's talk about the POC best friend. Some of the most famous rom-coms include Clueless and 10 Things I Hate About You, both featuring beautiful, skinny, white women. The two black women in these movies are subjected to playing the role of the protagonist's best friend. In Clueless, Dionne's role is narrowed down to matching Cher's energy, but never outshining her. In 10 Things I Hate About You, Bianca's best friend Chastity matches Bianca's energy, but never grows as a character like Bianca does. Instead, her purpose is to support her best friend instead of having her own character. We need more people of color to play main characters with their own personalities, their own backstories, and their own character development. UCLA reported that in 2018, there were 3 times more white actors than any minority film leads. In the same year, they reported that films with less than 30% minority actors performed the best at the box office, while films that featured a wide cast of minority actors performed poorly at the box office. A movie like Crazy Rich Asians with an all-Asian cast made over $250 million at the box office, becoming the highest-grossing romantic comedy in the last 10 years. We need more cultural diversity in our movies. We need to see ourselves on screen. Children deserve to see themselves in the movies they love to watch. We need more Asian, Black, and Hispanic actors to play the lead roles in all genres of film. Hollywood's laziness. The most common problem of screenwriters and casting directors is casting white actors in order to save the trouble of having to include their race into a storyline. Casting directors feel that in order to cast a person of color, they're going to have to add a subplot revolving around the character's ethnicity.
And casting directors, producers will come up with whatever excuse they can to not say, we're not going to hire a black person.
In fact, while it is important to acknowledge a person of color's ethnic background, a movie can still be made with the same plot if it includes a person of color. Many argue that actors are casted based on their talent and not their appearance. But in fact, only 25% of mainstream actors in Hollywood are people of color. That 25% including all minority races. If actors are selected based on their talent, why aren't more talented people of color being casted? And why are people going against more diversity? We need to be uplifting people of color and pushing the industry to further include more diversity. It shouldn't be a debate whether or not we're more inclusive. The entire industry needs to realize why we need more minority races displayed on screen. As Hollywood's progress continues, I know that one day in the near future, we will be able to see full ethnic diversity on the big screens as we go to enjoy the newest blockbusters.